Hey everybody, Antoni here with a review of Bizet's Carmen with conductor Jacques Lacombe, which I saw last night at the Deutsche Oper Berlin. This marked the third time I saw this particular production of Carmen because Ramona Zaharia took over an indisposed Stephanie Dustrac. Now, going to Ramona Zaharia as Carmen, she is a mezzo-soprano whose career I have been following ever since I was 19 years old, and she boasts a huge repertoire from the contralto roles of Ulrika, Zita, and Erda to the true dramatic mezzo parts of Amneris and La Principessa di Bouillon, to the Zwischenfach roles of Eboli and Santuzza, and even to her signature role of Carmen, a role that she has been singing all throughout Europe. Now, what I really liked about her performance is that she was able to be sultry, sensual, defiant, independent, and fiery. Not to mention, she was absolutely gorgeous in this part. She was able to use her slim and sleek physique to convey this iconic gypsy so well. And even though I thought her singing was quite good for the most part, especially in the high notes, most specifically when she launched a high B flat in the seguidilla, there were times I thought that her singing was quite tentative in both the middle and the lower range, which was quite a shame because since she boasts such a huge repertoire ranging from contralto to the Zwischenfach roles, you would think that she would be able to dig in through those chest tones and be capable of using a proper head voice. Last night's performance made me see that the tentativeness of her vocal performance kind of drowned what could have been a great performance of Carmen. So I really hope that Ramona Zaharia irons out those flaws, develops her chest voice even further, and develop a more proper head voice. As her performance as Carmen stands, it's all right at best, because even though she was able to give off such a fine theatrical performance, I still think that her voice needs a lot of work, especially considering that she really needs to use a lot more chest and develop a proper head voice. What I could definitely see is that she has a lot of potential to be great, and once she irons out all these flaws in her vocal performance, this would be a mezzo that I will definitely be rooting for. And especially considering that she is at the height of her powers, and I would love to see her career develop much further. Making his role debut at the Deutsche Oper Berlin as Don José was Joseph Calleja. Now, even though I thought he was able to act the part well in terms of giving him a lot of passion, rage, fury, and a lot of blood and guts, and even though I thought his voice was well projected all throughout the theater, there was one thing that kind of annoyed me, especially when he started singing all of these spinto tenor roles, and this problem has been quite pervasive, and that is his overall caprino slash tremolo emission, which also doesn't help that he had such a nasal voice. To me, that nasal quality in his voice does not sound pleasing at all, even though he managed to sing this part with such abandon. And I really hope that Mr. Kalea irons out that particular flaw in his voice because he has good material. It's just that his technique leaves a lot to be desired, which is also quite a shame because we could have had other tenors sing this iconic anti-hero. We could have had Misha Didik, Martin Mühle, and Theodor Ilinczai, just to name a few spinto tenors or even dramatic tenors who could have done this part a lot better. But as for Joseph Calleja, I thought that his voice was not so suitable for Don José, even though he did his best in this particular role. Making the leap from Frasquita to Micaela was Michot Marrero. And I thought that she was able to use her silvery and sweet voice to bring this country girl to life. She has an absolutely vivacious and vibrant stage presence, which has made her very well known no matter how huge or how small the parts she sang were. There were times that her voice was sadly inaudible, especially in her big aria, which is quite a shame because Michot Marrero has a lot of potential to become great. And I'm sure that once her voice fully develops into maturity, she can achieve greatness. But as of right now, she has a lot of potential. She still has time to develop that voice, and she is definitely a talent I will still be rooting for and hope that her voice develops in a very proper direction. Samuel Dale Johnson was solid as Escamillo. Unfortunately, we have at our disposal all the great baritones and bass baritones of the past who have sung this role with a lot more flair and a lot more exuberance and a lot more machismo. I thought that with Samuel Dale Johnson's vocal performance, he did a very good job in this role. He was focused in terms of his tone. He had a very dashing and tall and handsome stage presence. However, there were certain things that I was missing in his voice. I was missing that richness, roundness, and depth from any true dramatic baritone or even that of a bass baritone who sings Escamillo. In spite of all that, I still thought that he was able to stand on his own two feet. He has a lot of potential to grow, and I hope that his voice continues to develop in the right way. Byung-gil Kim was a dashing and absolutely handsome Tsuniga, and he was able to make a great use of this wonderful character part, all thanks to his fresh and young bass baritone voice, which has the potential to grow. He has been coming into his own into these deeper parts, and I want to hear his voice grow in richness and in depth, because as it is, it still sounds like a baritone trying to sing the bass parts. Nonetheless, he has potential to grow, and I hope that he grows in the right way. And as he was as an actor, he was quite strong in terms of his portrayal. He was able to be just as dashing and quite macho in that particular role, even though it is quite thankless. Philip Yekal was absolutely dashing as Morales, and this is a young baritone whose career continues to grow with full maturity. And as he sang this particular character part, his voice shone quite well. It still has the potential to be a lot fuller and richer, but as it is finely tuned. I just hope that he doesn't give in to bad habits. And I'm pretty sure that with a lot of discipline and a lot of grit and determination, Philip Yekal will become greater than he already is. There was also some fine singing done by, of course, Thomas Lehmann's dashing, handsome, and rugged Dancairo, Andrew Dickinson's lyrical, characterful, and charming Remendado, Amber Fasquelle's gorgeous, tall and sexy Mercedes, and Cornelia Kim, who managed to put her elfin features, her lamb-like countenance, and her lovely silvery voice to great use as Frasquita. So overall, the singing was decent, and I still have to commend the brave efforts done by Ramona Zaharia, Joseph Kalea, Michot Marrero, and Samuel Dale Johnson for taking on these roles head on. Sure, their voices could use a lot more development. Sure, their voices could use a lot more ironing out, especially where the problem spots are concerned. I hope that the careers of Ramona Zaharia, Michot Marrero, and Samuel Dale Johnson will blossom into full maturity and continue to develop in the proper way, because they have so much potential, and I would love to see them fully blossom and grow as singing actors. The conducting done by Jacques Lacombe was as brisk and fresh as it's always been. He managed to make a great use of the command of the orchestra, and he was able to bring in so much urgency and vibrance into the orchestra, even though there were times that they were lagging behind the singers and vice versa, which was quite problematic. Nevertheless, the orchestra and the chorus of the Deutsche Oper Berlin were fabulous, as they've always been. So overall, with a decent performance done by Ramona Zaharia, who has a lot of potential to grow and develop as a singer, as long as she irons out those problem spots properly, and some equally fine conducting done by Maestro Jacques Lacombe, this was an evening that was quite well spent, if only to see Ramona Zaharia offer what she can really do. And for those of you who watched this particular performance of Bizet's Carmen at the Deutsche Oper Berlin, what'd you think of it? Did you feel like Ramona Zaharia was up to par in her performance as Carmen? Was there another singer who stole her thunder? Or did you feel like the overall vocal performances did not really hold up really well? Comment below and let me know. Well, that's all for now. Be sure to tune in much later for my review of Verdi's Otello, also at the Deutsche Oper Berlin, starring Russell Thomas as Otello. So until then, have a great day, everybody, and have an equally great summer.